Good morning to all. Today I am going to discuss about the nature of the management. In previous video I explained the meaning of management. So management is what? Management consists of the planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Okay, so in this video we will see the nature of the management. So there are three types of nature of the management. First one is management is an art. Management is an art. Art means to apply, it is based on the practice and creativity. Means it is a theoretical knowledge. Suppose you are reading a book, then you get the knowledge. That is the theoretical knowledge. So what is management as an art is a totally existence of the theoretical knowledge. And it is personalized applicable. Personalized applicable means every individual has this different mindset. They study the same kind of book. Okay, so this is the personalized applicable, means every individual applies the things in differently. Now the next one is based on practice and capabilities. Practice, you know, the practice means the man perfect. So practice, if you doing regular practice, then you will apply better. Now next one is creativity. Creativity means you should do the things differently, means doing the things with different with each other. Okay, so this is the management of nature of management as a art. Now come to the next, management as a science. Science means what? Science means systematic body of knowledge. Okay, systematic body of knowledge, and this knowledge is universal validity. This is universal validity, means applicable in all over across the country. That is the management as a science. And science is comprised the exact principle which can be verified, and it can be established cause and effect relationship. Means it is based on the experiment, means cause and effect relationship. Now third one is management as a profession. So management as a profession means it does not meet the exact criteria of profession. It does have some features of the professions. In this professions we need well defined body of knowledge. Well defined body of knowledge means we have some degree. Okay, we need a degree to get the professions. Okay, in this professions there is a restrictions of entry, means no one can enter in the market. Suppose doctor should have a MBBS degree. Okay, MBBS or MD, they have the degree, MBBS degree. Lawyer have the lawyer degree. So every individuals have some kind of degree so that they can get the professions in this particular phase. That's why if you don't have any kind of degree, then you cannot enter into the professions. Like means you cannot become a doctor, engineer or lawyer. Okay, this is totally is the service motive industry. Provide the service, means doctor provide the service, teachers provide the service, lawyer provide the service. So this is the nature of the management. So nature of the management is what? There are three kinds of nature of management. First one is art, second one is science, and third one is professions. In brief, art is what? Art is the personalized application of a skill into the reality. That is the art. And science is what? Systematic body of knowledge. And the profession is you have a well defined of knowledge, means you have a degree of that particular field, and you and this there is a restrictions of entry. Okay, so this is the nature of management. Now come to the next, there is the functions of management. So functions of management, there are five functions of management basically. First is planning. So planning is what? Planning is deciding in advance. Deciding in advance what to do, how to do, for whom to do. Okay, so this is the meaning of planning. Means deciding in advance what to do, how to do, and this is the meaning of the planning. And meaning of organizing is what? Organizing means assignment of duties and establish the relationship between the employer and employee, or you can say the subordinate and superior. So organizing is basically the reporting relationship between the organizing relationship between the superior and subordinate. Okay, one more thing is important in organizing. They divide into the responsibilities and authority. So under this organizing we have two things, authority and responsibility. Authority means what? Authority means power to take decisions, means superior can take the decision on the basis of the their knowledge. So this is the authority. And the responsibility is what? Responsibility is the obligation to complete the task on time, means it is a duty to perform the task on time, that is called the responsibilities. Now come to the third one is staffing. Staffing means what? To finding the right person for the right job, that is the staffing. So under this, recruitment, selection, training and development, or you can say the orientations program. So basically staffing is what? Staffing is the manpower resources. So to put the right person for the right job according to their qualification, that is staffing. And how to get the right persons, there is some process of the recruitment selection, we will discuss later on. So basically we need to know the meaning of the staffing. Staffing is finding the person, right person for the right job. Okay, next one is directing. Directing is what? Directing means motivating the employer, motivating the workers, and providing some incentive, either in terms of the financial incentive or the non-financial incentive. That is directing. Directing is to provide the directions, to provide the path to achieve the organization's objective. Means how to get the achieve the objective? To motivate the employee, to direct the employee, to provide the leadership qualities, to give the leadership qualities among the people. So this is directing. Now next one is controlling. Controlling is what? Controlling is the last functions of the management. And first function of management is what? Planning. So planning is what? Planning is a futuristic process. Controlling is both. Controlling is the futuristic as well as the back, the futuristic forward process as well as the backward process. So in controlling, the meaning of the controlling is what? We have to analyze the actual performance with the standard performance. So what is the standard performance? Standard performance set by the organization. Suppose in any organization want to achieve 100 unit in a day, 100 unit in a day, that is the standard performance set by the organizations. But actual performance may be differ. Actual performance means the actually performance done by the employee. Maybe it produced only the 10 units of the goods, or you can say that 12 units of the goods. Anything can be happen, or maybe the 10 units of the goods produced in a particular day. So this is what controlling is, the deviations between the standard and actual, or actual and standard. So this is the basically the difference between the standard and actual performance. So you can easily see that the standard performance is almost 10 units. Now first case actual performance is 8. So what is the deviation? There is the negative deviations. Okay, so need to check whether the condition is good or not. Now the second condition is what? Second condition, the company sells the 10 unit of the goods and services for the particular date, but employees produce 12 units a day. So it means they perform very good, or you set the target lower than their capabilities. So this is the difference between the actual performance and the standard performance. So this is very important function of the management, because planning, organizing, staffing, directing, controlling, these are the separate chapter in your book. So you need to know about the meaning of this thing: planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. Okay, so these are the two things: nature of the management and the functions of the management. So hope you understood the concept of the nature of the management and the function of management. Now we'll discuss next video case study related to the first chapter. Okay, thank you.